self-defense and art of the serpent. So the common denominator that we're going to see displayed in every one of these applications is the use of a circle to separate her from an assailant. We're going to start with a very simple grab. So here he's grabbed this young lady, and she's not interested in letting him do that. So her first goal is to immediately respond and separate the grip. Looks like this. Again? Just a very simple rotation inside of you. Again? Just put things over the wall. That's the second one. That's all right. Again? Good. So a quick rotation. So we're trying to avoid force against force in this case. Now, in the event that a person is applying even extra force, what we're going to do is we're going to enlarge the circle so that about elbow height makes the circle a little bit easier to go with it. So again, he's playing a quick circle, should look long. Good. And so basically a little bit larger than the previous one, again, show the block. Again, one more time, show the block. Good. Okay, now let's assume for a moment that she needs a lot of energy. So here's a situation where she's now going to do a full-size circle and let that circle separate herself from the opponent. Again, a great big circle. I'll show her hand. So the idea is not to pull. If you're pulling and trying to escape by separating from the opponent, he's going to line up with you, and that's hard to do. But a circle is a lot harder to follow. So in this case, again, a big full circle. One more time, great big circle. So a circle can be used to separate yourself from the opponent. And the next movement would be a series of steps running away. But for now, we're just going to stay in place. All right, now let's assume something a little bit more lightly. But let's say a person grabs the shoulder. In this case, a very simple barrier. If she has rope behind her and the opportunity to just step away from the opponent exists, we don't want to resist the opponent. We're basically going to spin in a circle. So turning either right or left, spin away from the opponent. So simply spinning and escaping. Her next big thing would be to run, right? So we're going to leave off the run part so we can just move through this. So again, a person grabs the shoulder, a quick spin away. Either direction. Very hard for her to hold, for him to hold. The main thing that we're not doing is we're not grabbing the assailant's hand for the sake of trying to separate the hand from the shoulder. That won't work. The best thing to do is to just simply draw a circle in many different kinds of ways. So again, big circle. Alright, this time we're going to do a type of a grip that is a little bit more outside of the shoulders. So in this case, instead of just rotating, she's going to use a great big arc over the top. So either right or left hand, using the arc of the left hand, for example, going towards the right, to separate yourself from the opponent. Okay. So a simple circle can be used to do that. Alright, one more time. Again, big circle and quickly go. Now the other thing she's using is her legs and waist, but fundamentally, the thing to remember is the use of a circle. By the way, this is the free curriculum that we offer at our school. So for any of you that want to learn basic self-defense, this is a course that's free. We do this as a community service to the public. So please come and visit us and take advantage of this course. Now, this next one again is probably even more likely. Imagine a man strangling a woman. So now with the hands wrapped right around her throat, one of the things she does not want to do is try to grab those hands because his hands are very strong. So rather than go after the grip itself, we're going to use the arc of the circle. We say circle probably 100 times during that course. And we want to make sure that you understand the use of the circle. Applying a large arc with the right or left hand, we're going to escape using the circle. Ready? Begin! So again, she can just incorporate that with the run. All right, again. Either direction. Again, just whip the circle. Whip the circle. All right, one more time. Illustrate the circle this time. Just before you actually start that grab, put your hand by your side a little bit. Now, as soon as their touch makes its contact, that circle will blow. So it's simply, we want to restrict them. We don't want to give them a good grip on it to be deployed. So we'd like the circle to be applied instantly. So without any delay, as soon as you see that grab, knock those arms out of the way. So again, right away. So you limit the exposure to the grip itself. All right. Now, normally, the reason why we do this is because we don't want to escalate the situation. You don't want to make the guy more excited or more angry than he already is. He's already fired up, loaded with adrenaline, already committed a crime, right? So we don't want to try to normally try to escalate by striking him or struggling with him. So normally you know what to do. You just want to get away from the alarm. But in the rare instance that you just do not have any other option, and you have no place to jump from, this is a situation where you only have to do some practice. And there's two very weak spots in every human being. We all know where they are, right? So we're going to illustrate how you might use two very fast strikes to separate you from a very bad guy. Okay? So we're going to start to do this a little bit slower by grabbing the arm. And the two basic strikes that work really well are... Oh! One, two! So once to the groin and a claw to the eyes, pretty much a home run. Now notice how his feet are apart to support his weight. That means that any kind of a kick is going to glide itself upward like a funnel towards his arm. So you don't have to be tremendously skilled to pull this one off, but you don't necessarily have it until absolutely necessary. So a very good shot to the groin, any part of the leg works, and then a poke to the eye is pretty much in this situation. Can we relate? Alright, one more time real quick. So we recommend only as a last case scenario that we would use a technique like this. We highly recommend instead practicing the art of the circle. So what I would recommend to do is come on down to business and we can show you a little bit more how that might work.